Hey, up, it's Steve from the Old Yorkshire Geek. Bit of news. This is a little fun story that I just came across the other day. So I'll make myself teeny tiny, like so, and then we'll have a look at this news story. This is from Slash Film. Whitney Seibold, Star Wars' laughably horrible attempt at making a fake Luke Skywalker head. Remember from Empire Strikes Back? Right, in Irving Kirshner's 1980 sci-fi epic, The Empire Strikes Back, the rebel hero Luke Skywalker, Mark Hamill, in case you didn't know, travels to a distant planet called Dagobah. We don't actually know how far away Dagobah is. But anyway, to hone his nascent mental powers with the gnome-like sage Yoda, Frank Oz. During his training, Luke learns about the Force, Frank Oz, and I think a chimpanzee at one point as well. Luke learns about the Force, the godlike spiritual entity that binds the universe together. He learns to better move objects with his mind and also to vaguely see into the future. Yoda warns Luke that directing one's Force-inspired powers toward violence and selfish desires can lead one toward the dark side, a corrupting, demonic facet of the Force that encourages evil. Blah, blah, blah. We all know this, don't we? As a demonstration of the dark side, Luke has a vision in a cave. He sees a ghostly imprint of Darth Vader, David Prowse, voiced by, James Earl Jones, but not in this bit. The fascist warlock who killed one of Luke's old friends. Warlock. That was the late, great... His name's bloody gone out. It was recently... He's deceased, and because he went wandering off into the mountains, and they found his body after months and months, didn't they? He was the warlock, wasn't he? Battling against the other fella whose name I bloody blanked on. What am I like? Luke has a slow motion duel with the masked Vader, and in a fit of murderous anger, severs Darth Vader's head. Hey, we're getting to it now. He looks down at the mask without warning. It blasts open. Instead of seeing Darth Vader's face inside, however, Luke sees his own dead eyes looking up at him. He was Darth Vader. The worst evil Luke finds is the evil coming from within him. It's a chilling nightmare sequence in a sci-fi action picture that's already bleak and downbeat. And amazing. To achieve the effect of Luke Skywalker's severed head, as one might guess, Hamill merely poked his own head through a hole in an artificial dirt floor and pushed his face up against the blasted open Darth Vader mask. It would, one might assume, be the most logical way to film a severed head. Hamill revealed on Twitter in 2016, however, that an early version of the scene involved a rubber head and not Hamill's own. The rubber head looked quite bad, and we'll get to it. The rejected head. In 2016, Hamill responded to a fan who asked if that was indeed his head in the Empire Strikes Back dream sequence. He noted that it was saying simply that it was my head protruding through an opening in the set floor as I stood below. My prop head was tested but rejected. Star Wars obsessives naturally had some of the test photos of the Mark Hamill prop head. And an image of it eventually surfaced in Hamill's Twitter feed the following year. One can take a look at it and judge for themselves if the filmmakers made the right choice. It's a high-quality rubber head, of course, but it doesn't look exactly like Mark Hamill. And here it is. There it is. That's it. It's better than I could do. But rubber heads are a bit... Should have got Kevin Yeager to do it, who did like Sleepy Hollow and films like that. Starship Troopers, he did that as well. He were good at heads, with Kevin Yeager, and it probably still is. So there we go. Mark Hamill, unused dummy head rejected in favour of using my real head pushed up from beneath the set. Hard to keep my eyes open with all that smoke. There we go. But anyway, so that's the... I won't say it's laughably horrible, though, like the headline suggests, but anyway. The actor's comment, unused dummy head, rejected in favour, blah, blah, I've just read that. Since Yoda was a puppet operated by Oz, the Dagobah set was already elevated, making the real head effect that much easier to achieve. Hamill, when playing his own severed head, had to keep his dead eyes wide open as the smoke cleared from the mask blowing it open. No, his head wasn't inside the mask when it exploded. But the smoke lingered on the set. Hamill doesn't mention how many takes it took for the shot to look right, but one can imagine it wasn't too many. Well, we don't know, do we? Released last year, the docuseries Light and Magic contained a scene in which some of the men who worked for Industrial Light and Magic, the special visual effects, animation and virtual production division of Lucasfilm, looked through an old prop warehouse in 1988 and they found the rubber head. They joked that it looked terrible and treated the prop rather indelicately. The head's current location is unknown, although it's likely in the same Industrial Light and Magic archive as it was in 1988. And here's the clip. There we go. There we go. Has it got audio? It's for kids. It's for kids, this Star Wars. It's for kids. Bring me the head of Mark Hamill. Bet more than one person said that over the years. How long's it go on for? Bloody hell, 4 minutes. No, we don't need to watch 4 minutes of it, do we? Oh, no, it's showing the clip. Right, fair enough. So we've seen him holding the head. So there we go. So there we go. But they eventually went. They didn't go with the rubber head. They went with the... Oh, there's a bit more here, look. There's a bit more behind-the-scenes fightage.
Here's Mark Hamill's head. You gotta chop
off. Here's Mark Hamill's head.
It happens, you know.
Looked as bad there as it does.
Oh, where this goes.
Oh, yeah, it's a good thing. Well, yeah.
No, I meant the fake head.
Isn't that what I meant?
I don't know.
The Stormtrooper gun, that's Han Solo's gun.
Oh, look what I found.
Here, Don, hold it for me. Bring me the head of
Luke Skywalker.
Play football with it. Go on. So there we go. Oh, down again. Stop it. Stop. So there we go. There we go. The laughably horrible attempt at making a fake Luke Skywalker head. It wasn't that bad, was it? It looks fine to me. But the real face looks better, obviously. So they made the right choice. But anyway, so there we go. So there we go. I'll leave it there. So there we go. I'll make myself big again. So we'll leave it there. Thanks for watching. Wherever you are, look after each other. And until next time, I'll see you there.